That's about the maximum capacity. Register now. If you're not a secure creditor, click the link in the room and become a secure creditor now. The information is coming forth. If you appreciate this information, donate in the room for my time, my energy, and my research. It's greatly appreciated. Donation information is in the room. Now, history reveals nations can be conquered by the use by three different methods. The most common is to conquer a nation by war. Tazadaq said, in times of peace, prepare for war, because peace doesn't last forever. The most common way is to be conquered by war. In time, though, this method usually fails because the captives hate the captors and they rise up and drive them out if they can. Much force is needed to maintain control, making it expensive for the conquering of a nation by war. Second method is by religion. Where men are conceived, they must give their captors part of their earnings as obedience to Yahuwah. Such a captivity is vulnerable to philosophical exposure or by overthrow by armed forces, since religion by its nature lacks military force to regain control once its captives become disillusioned. The third method to conquer can be called an economic conquest. It takes place when nations are placed under tribute. Without the use of visible force or coercion, so that the victims do not realize that they've been conquered, such it is today. Tribute is collected from them in the form of legal debts and taxes. And they believe they are paying it for their own good, for the good of others, or to protect all from some enemy. Their captors became their benefactors and protectors. Now, although this is the slowest to impose, it is quite long-lasting. And the captives do not see any military force arrayed against them. Their religion is left more or less intact. They have freedom to speak and to travel, and they participate in elections for their rulers without realizing it. They are conquered, and the instruments of their own society are used to transfer their wealth to their captors and make the conquest complete. In the 1900s, the average American worker paid few taxes and had little debt. Last year, payments on debts and taxes took more than half of what we earn. Is it possible? Or is it not possible that this is a form of conquest that has actually been imposed upon the people? I want you to listen to me, man, real good, man. And then you decide for yourself. And may Yahuwah have mercy on this once debt-free and great nation. And HaMashiach, Yahusha, hallelujah. Again, let me give you the real story of the money control in the United States that used to be America. The mother says to the judge, and judge, we were always in debt. See, I saw a cartoon, a mother standing in front of a judge in divorce court, holding the hand of a small boy and girl, right? The hand, well, with her husband sitting in the witness chair, holding his head in gloom. And the mother had the audacity to say to the judge, "Judge, we were always in debt." America, living in what is called the richest nation on earth, seemed always the shortest on money. The women now working in unprecedented numbers. Husband hoping for overtime to earn more or to take part-time just over broke jobs. Evenings and weekends, children look for odd jobs for spending money. The family debt climbs higher and higher and higher. And psychologist says one of the biggest causes of family quarrels and breakups and arguments is over money. For the love of money, Matthew, my brother, is the root of all evil. The love of money. Not money, but the love of money. Is that what I told you? Too few American people realize why these so-called chairmen and statements and political powers wrote Article 1 of the United States Constitution. Congress shall have the power to coin money and regulate the value thereof. They did this. Yo, they did that, you all. And as the foul-mouthed Kahan will show in prayer for hope, that it will prevent love of money from destroying this nation and restore the republic that was founded. And we're going to see how subdivisions and subversions of Article 1 has brought all this evil of which Yahuwah had won. So I'm going to tell you this, Matthew. Money is the only creation that man has created. Everything else he procreated. Money is man's only creation. See, economists use the term create. They have aphasia. Like Wendy Williams, they have aphasia. I've been using the word for years, so don't say I got it from them. They got it from the foul mouth Kahan. Economists use the term create when speaking of the process by which money comes into existence. Now, creation means making something which did not exist before. Understand that. We're going to deal with specifics. And if you're not a secure creditor by the time this video over, man, you had a lobotomy. Without being a secure creditor, there's no hope. You got to correct your status. Watch this. Yahushua be. A lumberman make boards from trees. Workers build houses from lumber. And factories manufacture automobiles from metal, glass, and other material. But in all these, my good brother Matthew, they did not create. They only changed the existing material into a more usable substance and therefore more valuable form. This is not so with money. Here and here alone, man actually creates something out of nothing. Creates money out of thin air.